I would like to demonstrate how to use the interactive deconvolution and fusion tool in Huygens to combine 8 rotational views of a Drosophila brain that were imaged with a light sheet microscope into a single combined fused image. So let us select the input data set, 8 views that are 45 degrees rotated with respect to each other. We see the thumbnails appear in 3D as the images are loaded, and we can see that the rotation is along the axis that is in the vertical direction in these previews. We can open the tool by selecting all the thumbnails and then selecting the interactive fuser and deconvolution tool. And then when the window opens, by default, it shows all of the 8 input views on the sidebar on the left side. And only the first 2 are selected. So the very first view is displayed in red, and it is the reference or the stationary view. The second one, displayed in green, is the moving view. And it is displayed in this way because we can now start to manually overlay the images. I can drag the green image with the mouse and then position it in such a way that it overlaps with the red image. So now the view is mostly yellow and these 2 views are aligned. And in our experience, a good way to align multiple views, such as the 8 views that we have in this example data set, is to always have one view visible in red, namely the one that was added last, and then add one next view in green and overlay it. So at any given time, we are only looking at the overlap of 2 individual views at the moment, and then we can clearly see if they are overlapping correctly or not. And in this way, we can relatively easily have them all overlaid. And now if I'm completely through the list, I should select all of the input views if I want to combine all 8 of them, because now I'm selecting the checkbox use them in the fusion result. For a final check if all the 8 views are overlaid correctly, I can switch the color scheme from red-green into global. And now we are looking at a single channel out of the 2 channels from each input view, and that channel from each view is displayed in its own color scheme, or color scale. So the colors in this case do not represent different wavelengths, but they represent the different views for a single channel. I can also switch to the other input channel, and now for the second channel, all of the 8 input views have their own color. I can see in the overlay that the 8 views are at least approximately aligned with each other. So I'm happy with that overlay so far. Now I can start the automatic process, but first I can select which region in 3D I would like to have included in the resulting image. So if I know that the data set is from the right side up to here, I can, with the cropping box, I can restrict the region that will be included in the result and that will be taken into account also in optimizing the relative positions. Now I select that in this case I want to have a rough optimization on the initial guess of the positions that I gave it. It will then still fine-tune the initial guess and try to optimally align each of the views. I want to include both channels in the result, so now I'm ready to press the start button. Right on top of here it will give an estimate that it will take 1.21 gigabytes of memory to perform the fusion in this case. Let us start the process. Huygens will now go through the views one by one, or two at a time actually, and it will incrementally add each new view to the result that has been already fused until this moment. So it will first, for each view, attempt a few different shifts along the main axis of rotation, as that is what we see happening here. That is the only shift that is not yet specified in my initial guess. So it will do that automatically, and then we see the overlap view slightly moving. That means that Huygens is attempting slight variations on both the position and the orientation. So it is a rotation and a shift that it is attempting to optimize for each of the views. And then once it does not change anymore and it has found the optimal position, it will combine each of the views into the fused image. Now, the fusion itself, it tries to combine the best parts of each of the input images. So for each location in the result, Huygens will try to determine which of the input views contains the best information for that region. Usually, of course, that would be the side where the light sheet is coming from and the side where the detection objective lens is located. And in the custom options, you can specify that you would like, for example, to get a blend of all the input images with weight factors applied, weight factors that depend either on the position or on the information content of all the input images. Or alternatively, to blending the views, you can also specify that at each location in the result, you just want to copy the pixel value from the best available view at that position. So then you get a combination of the views in a different way. Now Huygens is busy with optimizing the last view. It has included the last view, and now it informs me that the result has been exported to the main window. So let us have a look at the main window. Now an extra thumbnail has appeared, which is the 3D thumbnail of the fused image. So this is the result of this procedure to combine 8 rotational views into one single image. I started the Huygens fuser and deconvolution again on the same dataset. I would like to demonstrate the effect of two options in the fuser. One thing to notice here is that we can see an outline of a rectangle, which represents the extent of the acquisition volume of each of the views. So we see in green an oblique rectangle and in red a rectangle. The fact that we can see those and that the background is not completely black, that means that there is a noticeable background level present in each of the input images. Now, if we would be doing a full deconvolution on each of the input images, the background would be removed. But even if we don't do that, the background can also be removed just in a fusion process by selecting this option Subtract Background. And I would also like to show the effect of the multi-resolution optimization. So I will accept those two changes. And then without manually overlaying the two input views this time, and also without selecting a crop region, I will just start the fusion process on two input images. Now, after the axial position has been estimated, here we can see the multi-resolution option at work. Huygens starts to optimize the orientation and the position at a very coarse resolution level. So we see a highly blurred version of the image, And then on that level, it estimates the position, and it has correctly found that the moving view should be moved to the right with respect to the stationary view in this overlay window. And now as the process continues, you can see it refining to finer and finer resolution levels. So the end result would be the same as it would have been if I had given it a correct initial estimate of the shift at an accuracy of 1 to a couple of pixels. But now it has automatically found this relatively large shift that was present between the red and the green images in the initial view. So if I'm happy with the overlap that it has found so far, let it fuse the result. And now in the main window, indeed we see that the background has been removed, because now the background is black. And here we have a three-dimensional thumbnail of the fused image of just the first 2 out of 8 input views. Thank you for your attention. If you would like to have a free trial of the software, please visit our website at www.svi.nl.